Alright, Mr. Sotko here, and welcome to another Company Heroes 2 cast. And today is a 2v2 on the map, and I'm not very good at French, so I believe it's Lierno, or Lierenois, one of the two. And the teams today are, we have Private First Class Bull, and as the Russians, we have the Brood War JC, which is a great game, brings back quite a bit of memories. Played that game for probably way too long. Go ahead and take off the Fog of War here. And move on over to the OKW player, who is Walther Wenck. And the Wehrmacht player, Mitt Power. First and foremost, we have Sturm Pioneers moving out to the center, as well as engineers moving out to the center. The American Echelon troops immediately building a fuel cache. These troops are dangerously close to one another. If the Sturm Pioneers get close enough, they will defeat those Russian engineers. And the Wehrmacht choosing to go north, taking the capture points. Conscripts and riflemen moving in to these Sturm Pioneers. These engineers are going to take heavy losses, but so are the Sturm Pioneers by the conscripts and the riflemen firing at a large, far distance there. Rear echelon troops moving around the corner, going to get the flank off on these Sturm Pioneers. Sturm Pioneers doing a pretty good job of holding out, but just couldn't do it. Had to retreat. Wehrmacht up north, still taking the northern sectors, now bringing an MG42 for a little bit of suppression defense. Sturm Pioneers seeking cover here, as well as the American troops seeking cover, and at the same time, taking the standard territory point. Meanwhile, the Russians stay back to capture the fuel point in the center. Sturm Pioneers moving a little closer. Three echelon troops, two Sturm Pioneers. And those riflemen are now pinned by this Kubel wagon. Sturm Pioneers being fired on by conscripts and more riflemen moving in here, but this Kubel wagon may get the suppression off. It has to stand still for just a moment, and then it will get a little icon above it, and that means it can suppress troops, but it has to remain still for a solid few seconds. There it goes. Wehrmacht still taking the northern ends. Now the MG42 team moving over to the extremely important fuel point up top. Kubel wagon and an MG42 assault in this house with riflemen inside. So far, the Mitt Power has not chosen a commander, but the other commanders have been chosen. We have Lend-Lease Tactics, Rifle Company, and the Fortifications Doctrine. Sturm Pioneers moving across here, maybe taking some of these flags. Riflemen trying to hide behind this building here. If they are inside the building, then these will all fire on them, but if they're on the other side, then they can't see them. Sturm Pioneers repairing this Kubel wagon. Now moving up to get the kills on these riflemen who are suppressed and have to retreat out of there. They're not gonna be able to do anything while they're retreated there. And they're just gonna take a big beating from these Sturm Pioneers, and there they go. But they didn't make it. The riflemen have been defeated there. Sturm Pioneers firing on these riflemen, while the Wehrmacht is still just sort of taking everything up top. And if they don't stop that Wehrmacht up there, then the US allies are gonna be in trouble here pretty soon. Kubel wagon has its engine damaged, but not too big of a deal because of all these forces here able to back it up. Two squads of Sturm Pioneers and Volksgrenadiers against just one rifleman, and they are definitely out of there. Conscripts in this building here defending this territory might be able to get shots on anybody that's going to be trying to take that. Now we have a 8cm Granatwerfer mortar team. Still no Wehrmacht commander choice just yet. Probably waiting for a good time, waiting for just to see exactly what he's going to need. And the top has almost been completely taken by the Wehrmacht, and now he looks like he's going towards this victory point. And the bottom is now being taken by the Allies. MG42 team in this building here, suppressing these troops. That's kind of a pretty good building. Very hard to get to that building.
Ready!
Volksgrenadier is taking the center fuel point, where the Wehrmacht engineers are creating a fuel cache.
Pioneers ready for anything!
The battle is about to commence.
Rear echelon troops and engineers all coming down to the sector down here and maybe taking this next. But it seems like the Wehrmacht and the OKW know that they're down here. Setting up a little defensive area here. Unfortunately, they're going to be coming up through this path, so this Kubel wagon isn't going to be facing the proper direction. Two Volksgrenadier squads and the Grenadwerfer under fire from these riflemen. Losing troops, and these guys need to respond to that. Kubel wagon assaulting these engineers here, whereas the rear echelon troops are trying to maybe get the flank here on this Kubel wagon, but the engineers had to retreat. And Sturm pioneers are going to meet these rear echelon troops and tear them up. Seems like possibly the Americans or the Russians actually took the Grenadwerfer order.
Heads up! Enemy infantry in force!
Let's give them hell, boys!
Keep it up! Pour it on!
Riflemen with what appear to be the Browning. Two conscripts moving up. And need to seek the cover right here in order to not get suppressed as easily. But there isn't an MG-34 here, and they did increase the MG-34 suppression ratio, so these troops got suppressed pretty quick there. And there's just a little bit too much here for this Russian alone to handle right now. They need to get some mortars maybe and hit this MG-34. Battlegroup headquarters being produced over here. A little ways in the back, a pretty good spot to have it. Just run some troops back and go ahead and reinforce them and heal them up. Now the Axis creating a defensive position down here in the bottom, taking the majority of the map. Got a Dushka heavy machine gun here, suppressing these troops. Now the Dushka received a bonus to its suppression and to its armor penetration because it was a little bit underpowered before, but the recent patch did increase it a little bit, gave it a good buff. Now an MG-34 and an MG-42. Moving on up here, seeing if they can suppress and get some kills up on this Dushka. And starting to push back up top a little bit, which they definitely need to do, because if they don't push back up top and the bottom, they're definitely going to be starved for resources, and the Axis are going to have a lot more. MG-42 in this building, Sturm Pioneers, two squads of Sturm Pioneers moving up with their automatic rifles, trying to get a bunch of kills here, trying to push this Dushka out of the way. They really need to get that out of the way. The suppression of it is just a little bit too much. Rifleman up top here, trying to move up, but getting suppressed by this MG-34. That pesky MG-34 is just in the way. 82mm mortar squad. Not really doing too much right now because they are getting chased up, but now they should be moving forward again. Engineers down here taking the bottom victory point. Just out of sight of this MG-42 here. For anybody that doesn't know, the difference between the MG-42 and the MG-34 was that the 34 came out earlier and it has a slower rate of fire, but it was a more well-made gun. Each part was pretty much handcrafted, whereas the MG-42 came out a little bit later, has a much, much higher rate of fire. But it was sort of a stamped and milled gun, and it wasn't as high quality as the MG-34. Engineers down here in combat with these grenadiers, but they have a flamethrower, so that's definitely going to give them an advantage there, chasing away these grenadiers. Riflemen moving up on the center fuel point. Whoever controls this fuel point definitely is going to control the game. They're going to need both of these fuel points. Because in the end game, tanks are definitely the king of the game, for the most part. And if you don't have the fuel at the end of the game, you're going to be in a lot of trouble. Two Sturm Pioneers on these riflemen. I think that's going to waste these riflemen pretty quick here. They're going to want to get out of there. Volksgrenadiers coming up with their Panzerschrecks. Nothing to use the Panzerschrecks on just yet, but better safe than sorry. engineers now moving across to this standard territory point right under the German line here.
Ready to deploy! Heavy machine gun!
So they might be able to move these up after they take this and take out some MG34 and mortar teams. Top's still pretty much uncontested. I'd like to see some engineers or something run up here and try and take some of this stuff. Conscripts taking a big hit from that mortar. Or let's see where that came from. Let's see here. Here. Aiming directly at these conscripts. And now they're gone. That was a pretty brutal hit there.
What the hell am I gonna do with these? Stand by! Green as green can be.
50 cal in this building here, watching all this. But the real action's over here, and those engineers did indeed come up through here and got a couple kills, but just way too much machine guns up here for them to handle it. Now retreating, and these conscripts throwing mortars, or a napalm Molotov cocktail right on all these. It was definitely a good throw. Hit all those machine guns. Forced them to move back a little bit. But unfortunately for the Allies, the Axis have a battle group headquarters right here, so all they have to do is just move their troops right back and they can heal and reinforce. So they can pretty much just continuously fight until that is destroyed. So these riflemen really don't have a chance, because anything they kill is just going to run right back there and reinforce at the moment. New squad of riflemen moving up. But not going to be able to do too much. There's just a lot of German firepower going on right here and right now. And Panzer IV moving down into the center. Start regulating. Grenadiers with a bunker here, guarding this victory point. Or the standard point, anyway. And the victory point being taken by the Axis. Panzer IV in full reverse, getting hit by possibly grenades here. Nope, didn't get hit by anything. Totally full health. Riflemen moving up behind. Maybe they should throw an anti-tank grenade. These have the bazooka here. If they can get a shot off and hit the rear armor, that would be pretty nice for them. Germans moving up, Sturm Pioneers, Volksgrenadiers, and an MP-34. All assaulting this whole area here. Anything in this area here is in the kill zone, that's for sure. Grenadiers moving in. Trying to defend this Panzer IV here. Trying to stop these bazooka hits from hitting that Panzer IV. Doesn't want to lose that. Got an M5 half-track filled with guard squads down here assaulting the munitions point. And now the Russians moving up, trying to take the fuel point again. And this fuel point is just being contested over and over. It's just falling back into enemy hands and then allied hands. Grenadier should seek cover right behind this truck, and that would help him out quite a bit. MG-34 and an MG-42 here. Lots of fire. Any troops that move in here are just pretty much going to get instantly suppressed. It's pretty much a no-go unless you have mortars to destroy these or go around. Only two grenadiers left against these riflemen here, but they're going to have to move back through a grenade, and they're now completely suppressed, so they're not going to be able to do anything. They're going to have to go run home. Mortar out in the middle of nowhere here. This probably isn't the best spot for it. And that is the German mortar, the Granatwerfer 34 mortar team.
We lost a gun crew.
And just out here in the open, he did lose that mortar squad. And rear echelon troop just standing here with just one of him. And he doesn't have too much health. He needs to go back and heal up. M5 half track. Now moving up, taking another standard territory point. Mortar and two machine guns still at this area, covering this whole area here. Battlegroup headquarters still healing up, and we now have a Panzer Kampfwagen 2. Ausführung L, Luke's tank, moving out. And here we go with the half track with its Dushka heavy machine gun up in the front. And guard squads. Except this Panzer 2 is going to make short work of this half track. It's going to have to get out of there. Allies taking back the top sector here. So it might be a little bit too late as they are down 325, 471. Guard squads didn't make it out, nor did the half track. A big loss to the Russians. Now the Panzer II moving down to the southern side, see if it can find any allies down there, as well as the Panzer IV.
Field gun
But now the Allies are starting to bring out M1 57mm anti-tank guns, as well as the ZIS-3 76mm field gun. Although, unfortunately, at the moment, pointed at the wrong direction. All the tanks are down here, but they don't know that at the moment.
Ready for orders.
Area secure.
Regimental HQ for mechanized units will be here.
Schwerer Wehrmacht Schlepper. Turn it into a mechanized regiment headquarters up here. And we have the Schwerer Panzer headquarters over here, guarding this whole sector. Although I like to see these up front. I like to see them behind a building and up front in a strategical position, because they do very, very well against infantry, almost instantly suppressing infantry. And they are also very hard to take down without mortars or something like that. Panzer IV taking a big hit from these from this M1 257mm field guns, actually hitting at the same time. These grenadiers trying to stop these conscripts from getting to that Panzer IV. Meanwhile, taking the victory point. Molotov cocktail, but a throw and a miss. Rifleman squad with a captain moving down with a bazooka. But unfortunately, the grenadiers had the cover and the riflemen did not. Panzer II just doing some forest clearing down here, apparently. Stern Pioneers taking the southern munitions point. And the top still pretty much uncontested. I'd like to see something come across here. Even the lightest of a tank could come across and destroy that MG-42. Take it out. Axis taking the southern victory point, but at a high cost, as there seem to be raining mortars down on this victory point. ZIS facing the wrong way. Usually want to face that towards your enemy. There you go. Conscripts moving up into this MG-42, just now trying to take this top munitions, but instantly suppressed. But a good old smoke bomb can stop that, as the MG-42 squad will not be able to see in front of that, so they're going to have to reposition. Rifleman versus the Grenadier squad, but unfortunately the Riflemen were suppressed and fired slower because of that. Panzer II fighting this, not doing too good against a flamethrower there. Flamethrower not doing too good at the Panzer II, rather. And those conscripts did pick up the Panzer II, or the... Excuse me, I'm all tongue-tied today. The flamethrower. Two Dushka heavy machine guns right in the center. Watching the center fuel point. And the Allies were successful in taking out that MG-42 and will now have control over the northernmost fuel point.
Grenadiers ready.
But incoming of three Grenadier squads to seek vengeance on these Allies up here for taking their precious fuel point. An M4C Sherman with some pretty cool camouflage now on the battlefield. New set of engineers coming in. Now the Axis trying to take the center here. Obersoldaten moving in with their MG-34 light machine guns. But these two Dushkas are going to cause a lot of problems, as well as the 50 cal in this house here. Stern Pioneers moving up as close as they can so they can get best advantage of those automatic rifles. But unfortunately, they are in broken cover there. They're in open cover, and they're going to have to get out of there. Now two Panzer IVs up north, causing quite a bit of trouble up here. Gonna have to move these 57mm anti-tank guns up towards here. And this M4C Sherman should be moving up there as well. Rifleman with a captain moving on up, but getting pummeled by mortars. And they need to get out of there. They're in the middle of the road and are in totally open cover there. 57mm forced to move back as the engineers, the grenadiers, moved up on them. Only one grenadier left here. He might lose that grenadier. He's going to want to get that out of there. Dushka heavy machine gun sort of facing the wrong way, facing at these engineers, and they need to be facing this way. And the new patch did make it allow, make it able for you to manually face these. But fortunately, the Dushka in this house is facing this way. Riflemen taking back the victory point, but the Wehrmacht have taken the northern side back already. Allies at 205, Axis 469, so a definite advantage for the Axis this game. Two Shermans at the bottom, apparently avoiding the Panzer IVs and trying to do some damage on the bottom. I think they should move up and they could take out some of this stuff here pretty easy, except these do have a Panzer Shrek, so they're going to want to watch out for that. And they do not have the 50 cal machine guns on top of these, which is definitely not good. The 50 cals help with infantry and things like that, so without that, they have quite a bit less firepower. Conscript squad moving up with their flamethrower that they took from the engineers earlier, but unfortunately got suppressed and now have to run. Panzer IV in the back end, getting hit by this bazooka, trying to retreat as fast as it can, and these troops will not destroy that tank. Not today, anyway. Obersoldaten, Granatwerfers, and looks like an MG-34 running for their lives. Obersoldaten doesn't really have an answer for these tanks at the moment, just sort of soaking up some damage, being a distraction until the Panzer Shreks can get back. Ooh, a PAK-43 80mm anti-tank gun is almost completed, and if that gets completed, it virtually one-shots tanks. Watch how much damage this will do to this. Uh-oh. There we go. About half of its, a little bit more than half of its health gone in one hit. If it doesn't get out of there, and it has it at a very long range, two-shot at that Sherman. We have lost one of our armored vehicles. Although it is immobile. As you can see, its range faces all the way up to here, so if you have any tanks up to here, it will shoot them. And it hits them, and when it does, it hits them very hard. Sherman backing up, probably going home to get some repairs. New Sherman coming in. Still no 50 cal machine guns on the top of the Shermans, which I find very disappointing because that adds quite a bit of firepower. Allies trying to take the victory point back up here. There are two victory points right next to each other, so they might as well just kind of walk over here and take this one as well, because they definitely need it. They need to catch up. And a new MG-42 machine gun guarding this. Seems like a pretty good spot for this MG-42 as it guards all the way down here and for the most part all the way over there as well. Panzer IV getting repaired up. Half track moving along with some Panzer Grenadiers. Panzer IV making these troops over here run away. Couldn't get to the other victory point. And here comes the Axis. Gonna drop off the troops. Don't even need to drop them off, actually. Could just leave them in there. And gonna take this victory point back. Now the Allies down to 171. Axis 460. Not looking too good unless they can get those victory points back. Ooh, that was an instant devastation for those Volksgrenadiers. Flamethrower proving too much for them. Got a light artillery barrage coming in, or maybe zeroing artillery too. I think it might have been just a light artillery barrage, yep. And the mechanized assault doctrine for Mitt Power. And he has 14 command points, so he can build the Tiger. But he probably doesn't have enough resources yet. He only has 475 and only 89.90 fuel. Ur Echelon troops just trying to take this before they have to run away. Panzer IV taking a couple hits from this 57mm cannon. It needs to get out of there. He will lose that. And Panzer IV, it was a veteran too, so it had side armor on it. Pretty big loss for the Axis on that one. Sherman clear in the forest, backing up. Always fun to watch trees go down. Chasing the Echelon troops away, these Stern Pioneers are now taking this victory point back. Just as soon as these allies take these victory points, they are instantly taken back by the Germans, and that's definitely what you need to do. You cannot let your opponent have these victory points, because you obviously will lose. Riflemen now taking the position for the Stern Pioneers and taking the victory point back once again.
Where are they coming from?
Seems to be flip-flopping back and forth. Panzer IV must have hit a mine or something like that. Very damaged. And this Sherman should move up on that Panzer IV. But it seems to be just sitting there, and that's unfortunate. I think he could have got that kill. And that Panzer IV does appear to have hit a mine, instantly took out its engine, but here comes a Sherman Easy 8. And if he could just move up just a little bit, he could hit this Panzer IV right in the rear armor. And Panzer IV is gone. A big loss for the Axis.
One of our panzers has been
now moving destroyed. The Shermans back, making sure they don't take any additional damage. Making sure they don't get in the range of this Pack 43.
Yeah?
Easily one of the most powerful anti-tank in the game. Here comes another half-track with Panzer Grenadiers. Come to assault these riflemen here in the center. And once again, trying to take this victory point, flip-flopping back and forth and back and forth. Here comes some Sturm Pioneers to assist with that. Lost his half-track, but not too big of a deal there, as he can just call them in with the mechanized assault group. Center not seeing too much action. I think everybody sort of got weary of fighting in the center and no longer wants to do it, because there's just way too many machine guns on both sides. And allies pushing the Axis away once again to take the victory point once again. No more tanks left for the Axis that I see, whereas the allies have two Shermans and could easily make a comeback. Actually, three Shermans could easily make a comeback with all those Shermans. They could push something here and maybe push it up and under around this Pack 43. However, the Pack 43 can turn. It just takes quite a while. And the victory point now back in Allied control. But unfortunately, there are still victory points that are not Allied control, such as this one. And this one is Allied control, so the Allies are technically causing the Axis to fall in points at 171 to 437. Conscripts making some sandbag fighting positions right in the center, so they have somewhere to fight for when the Stern Pioneers run up on them just in time. And these Stern Pioneers are pretty much instantly going to get suppressed with that Dushka heavy machine gun and these flamethrowers. Definitely not going to happen. Incoming Tiger B. Tiger 2 moving up. Same thing, either the Tiger 2 or the Tiger B, whichever you want to call it. Moving across the battlefield here. Very imposing presence. Even sounds cool. Oversoldaten versus these conscripts. But getting hit by this Molotov, they're going to have to get out of there. Just fire everywhere. Fire flamethrowers and Molotovs. Tiger B getting hit by this 75mm pack howitzer, but not doing too much considering it's just the barrage ability.
Enemy flanking us.
Panzer Grenadiers and Grenadiers moving in on this Sherman Easy 8 and Mortar Squad, and they're going to have to get out of there. But that Sherman here is going to get hit by Panzer Faust and the Panzer Shreks. But its engine is damaged now, and may get hit again. Looks like he may lose this Sherman. Ooh, just lucked out there. Another Sherman Easy 8 against this Panzer IV. Panzer IV was faced a different direction, and they're definitely going to suffer the consequences for that. Tiger B being repaired right out in the open. Tiger B don't care. And that Sherman, or that Panzer IV, rather, was lost for the Axis. Tiger B moving up. Seeing if it can't get anything, but unfortunately there's a ZIS pointed directly at it. It's going to take some hits from that. But a deflective hit bounced off the front armor. And the armor on the Tiger B is just too good for the ZIS. Incoming Sherman here, trying to hit it from the side, trying to get to the weak armor, and now trying to move around it. The Tiger B is just very, very slow, so the Sherman is easily going to get around it. And now that the Tiger B is faced the opposite direction, this ZIS is going to do massive damage to its rear armor. But he loses it to a light artillery barrage. A new Sherman coming in, as well as a Sherman Easy 8. Both of them going to hit the rear armor, not the best way. He needs to turn this Tiger B around. There he goes. Getting hit in the side armor, though. Now down to half health. But now that it is facing the front of the Sherman, it's just not going to happen. Incoming bazooka team. And maybe gets a little bit of damage, but I doubt they will take that out. Allies still in control of the southern victory point, as well as the northern left side victory point. Another half-track incoming with Panzer Grenadiers trying to take this side, but I don't think that's going to happen this time, as there is a rifle squad, as well as a MG-42 that was picked up from the Axis team. Two Obersoldaten moving up on these conscripts, trying to clear the way for this Tiger B. But he definitely needs to pull this Tiger B back and start to repair it. 250 half-track just cruising along here, just about to lose it. Exits the Panzer Grenadiers, but they aren't going to last too long with all these troops around. A Major taking the top right victory point, and it's about time that the Allies actually came over here and decided to start assaulting the Germans. And if they have all three of these, they will start to win very quickly, and the Germans will fall very quickly. But the score so far, 149 to 400. So if the Allies want to win this, they're definitely going to have to hold all three of these for quite some time. We got a White Phosphorus smoke barrage incoming on these Panzer Grenadiers, as well as a M4 Sherman. Panzer Grenadiers are definitely burning there, and they will lose these Panzer Grenadiers if they don't retreat immediately. Incoming Tiger B moving down towards the south here, along with a Sturm Pioneer and Obersoldat in backup. Allies still controlling the top, and as well as the middle. Tiger B hit a mine there, definitely lost its engine. It is at a complete halt. Tiger B firing at some troops here, and the Sherman moving in. The engine is out on the Tiger B, however, the Tiger B can still defend itself by firing. But if the M4C Sherman can get around and hit the back armor, that Tiger B is definitely in trouble. Here comes a Sherman Easy 8, two Sherman Easy 8s, gonna hit the front side of this. And it does not look good for this Tiger B. Just a few more hits, and this Tiger B is down. It's engine is completely out. It's not going anywhere. Tiger B trying to defend itself desperately, firing at that Sherman Easy 8, doing quite a bit of damage too. And this Sherman Easy 8 may go down before the Tiger B goes down. And Tiger B is lost. A big, big loss to the Axis side. But it just goes to show the power of the German armor, as it took three of these tanks just to take that out, including a mine. Just to take that out. And the OKW did surrender because they just simply didn't have anything left. After they lost all the Panzer IVs and the Tiger B, they simply didn't have anything left. And the Allies had 1, 2, and this victory point they did not have. However, they could have easily taken it with this lieutenant squad moving up. So victory goes to the Allies this game, and the losers are the Axis side. But I hope you guys enjoyed this content. If you do, go ahead and like and subscribe. And as usual, I will see you guys next time.